Hey guys, welcome back to CodeWar. I'm Ramesh and this video is the second part of rectangle and square topic in graphics tutorial series. In the first part, I have explained how to draw a rectangle and square using rectangle function, but there was a limitation that we were able to draw only those rectangles whose sides are parallel to x and y axis. So in this video, I will explain how to rotate a rectangle and we will also create a simple animation using it. But before we start the coding part, we need some concepts to be discussed. Think about a rectangle drawn on a screen with width is equals to W and height is equals to H. Now if we know the X and Y coordinates of the center of this rectangle, we can easily calculate the X and Y coordinates of all the four vertices of this rectangle. For simplicity, let's assume the center of this rectangle as the origin. So now, we are basically dealing with four points, which we can use to draw a rectangle even using the line function, right? Okay, one more thing, the x and y coordinates of a point after rotation around the origin is given by x is equals to x cos theta minus y sin theta and y is equals to x sin theta plus y cos theta, where this theta is the angle of rotation and x and y is the coordinates of the point before rotation. So we can use this formula to find x and y coordinates of all the four vertices of our rectangle after rotation. But there is one problem, that this formula will give the location of a point rotated around the origin. Since the corners of a rectangle is rotated around the center of the rectangle and not the origin, so a couple of steps need to be performed to be able to use this formula. So first we need to set the points relative to the origin. That means we will have to assume the center of rectangle as the origin so that the coordinates of all the vertices changes accordingly. Then we can use the rotation formula and after rotation, we need to move it back relative to the center of the rectangle. Now let's implement it in code. Okay, as we need some math functions for this, so including math.h. Now let me write the function first, then I will explain it. So, our function is ready. You can use this function to draw a rectangle rotated at any given angle. Now explaining this function. Here the first two arguments cx and cy represents the x and y coordinates of the center of the rectangle. This w represents the width of the rectangle, This h represents the height of the rectangle, and this last argument is the angle of rotation with respect to x-axis in clockwise direction. You can see I have initialized it with 0, so it is optional, and if you don't provide any value for angle, then by default 0 will be assigned to it, and this function will behave same as the rectangle function which we have seen in previous video. Now in the function body, first we have to convert the angle value from degree to radian. So here I have declared a variable theta of double data type and initialize it with angle modulus 180 multiplied with m underscore pi by 180.0. Here you can notice that I have divided angle by 180 to get a reminder. This is to make sure our rectangle looks accurate at every multiple angle of 180 degree. In the next two lines, I have declared two integer variables, dx equals to half of w and dy equals to half of h. Actually, rectangle has a property that all the vertices of a rectangle is at equal distance from center of rectangle. So if we consider the center of rectangle as the origin, then we can use this dx and dy to calculate the x and y coordinates of all the vertex of rectangle. Now in the next line, I have declared an integer array of size 8. Actually, I am using it to store x and y coordinates of all the vertices of rectangle after rotation. Here all the values at even position represents the x coordinates, and all the values at odd position represents the y coordinates. In this line, you can see I have used rotation formula to find x coordinate, assuming the center of rectangle as the origin, and then added cx to set it back relative to the actual position of rectangle. In the next line, I have calculated the y coordinate, assuming the center of rectangle as the origin, using the rotation formula, and then added cy to set it back relative to the actual position of the rectangle. And in the same way, I have calculated rest of the x and y coordinates after rotation. Okay, so now we have x and y coordinates of all the four vertices of our rotated rectangle, and we can easily draw our rectangle using these values. So finally, here in the for loop, I have used line function to draw all the four sides of our rectangle. I have already explained about line function in fourth video of this tutorial series. You can watch it for more details on line function. I have mentioned the link in the description of this video. Okay, here you can notice one thing, that I have written I plus 2 modulus 8. So you may ask, why modulus 8? See, in this for loop, initially I is equals to 0, I must be less than 8, and in every iteration I is incremented by 2. So possible values of I is 0, 2, 4 and 6. When I is equals to 6, here we will have I plus 2, that is 6 plus 2 is equals to 8, but our array is of size 8, that means we can access array index from 0 to 7 only, right? But here we are getting 6 plus 2, that is 8. So here it will be an error, which is known as array index out of bound. And to solve it, I have written modulus 8. So when it will be 8, it will be divided by 8, and we will get reminder 0. And at that time, this will represent this value. And in the same way, this will represent this value. Now let's call it in our main function. Rectangle, rotate 320, 240, 200, 100, 50. Now build and run it. So here 320 and 240 represents the x and y coordinates of the center of the rectangle, and this 200 represents the width of the rectangle, this 100 represents the height of the rectangle, and this 50 represents the angle of rotation with respect to x-axis in clockwise direction. Okay, Here in the build message tab, you can see there is some warnings which says narrowing conversion of this from double to int. So why are we getting this warning and how to solve it? See, the sine and cos functions basically returns a value of double data type, and therefore after calculation of this we will get a result of double data type. But the problem is this array can store only the integer value, so our result is implicitly converted from double to int data type. For example, suppose after calculation of this we got a value, let's say 100.25, then after conversion from double to int data type we will get 100. So here basically we are losing some data, or you can say our data has been narrowed up. And according to C++ 11 standard, the compiler has to warn you if a narrowing conversion happens, and this is the reason why we are getting this warning. And to solve this, we will have to explicitly tell the compiler to typecast it to int data type. So write int within parentheses before all of these. Now again build and run it. See, we have solved this issue and there is no warnings. Okay, in this graphics tutorial series, till now we have not done any animation related stuff. So let's create a simple animation using the function we have just created. In our animation, every time before we draw anything, we will have to clear our graphics window. So write clear device. This function is used to clear the graphics window. Now let's draw the rectangle using the function we have created. Rectangle, rotate, 320, 240, 200, 200, comma I. Here you can notice that I passed I as an argument for angle of rotation. So in every iteration, the angle will change and it will appear as the rectangle is rotating. Thereafter, we have to swap buffers. So write swap buffers. Well, this is a wide topic, so I will explain it later in a separate video. For now, just understand that I have used it to make sure our animation looks smooth. Now in every iteration, we will have to delay our program's execution for a short period of time so that we can easily see what has been drawn on the screen. So write delay 5. This delay function takes one positive integer which represents the time in millisecond, and it delays the program's execution for given time in millisecond. So our program is complete. Now let's build and run it. So this is our first animation created using graphics.h in this tutorial series. Simple and smooth. We will create some more cool and complex animations later in this tutorial series. Okay, here you can see this rectangle, actually it is a square, it is rotating in clockwise direction. To make it rotate in anti-clockwise direction, simply add a negative sign here. Now again build and run it. Here we go. So guys, that's all for now. I hope you liked this video. In the next video, I'll explain about drawing circle using graphics.h. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.